Oh my God, it's a self-driving bike. When a motorcyclist is 28 times more likely to die than someone in a car, there's a lot of reasons to roll out safety features in motorcycles. One of the features that could end up on bikes on the road is object avoidance. If they can start to figure out what the best way is for a bike to stop in certain situations, then this is something that they can add as a safety feature to a bike later. And this will be as a result of the bike learning to drive itself. The end goal is not to sell a self-driving motorcycle, but to create assistance systems that can help reduce the risk. It's impressive. We're not going to take anything away from this demo, but we're not actually seeing the bike drive itself. We're seeing it follow a GPS track. The bike itself doesn't have any environmental sensors. In addition to telling the bike where the track is, they had to set parameters, for example, the width and composition of the track before it heads out to drive around. So if you take a look at the bike itself, you can see that it has 70 kilograms of additional equipment tacked onto it. It has some custom BMW equipment, it has some off-the-shelf kind of stuff. The point of this bike is to kind of develop systems to make bikes a lot safer, right? So maybe this can automatically shift to put you in the right gear. Let's say you're a learner. Or maybe it's going to have some optical sensors down on the bottom, which this bike actually does have, and then it actually shoots them down at the road to check out the surfacing. So maybe it changes the drive style in order to make it a little more comfortable for you. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. This is a pretty complicated topic that's very exciting. Nicole Scott here for Mobile Geeks.